Fonterra reported a $605 million loss yesterday in a delayed announcement. That compares to a $196 million loss in the last financial year. The loss is triggering a big asset sell-off and job losses. How the co-op performs is highly important to our economy, and it can have knock-on effects for many of us. Dairy Environment Leaders Forum Chair and dairy farmer Tracey Brown joins me now for some reaction all the way from Kerikeri. Morena, Tracey.
Morena, Hayley.
So what is your immediate reaction as a dairy farmer to the news of the financial loss?
Well, obviously the results are disappointing and it's not okay. But they're realistic. Obviously, this is the co-op's worst ever result, but we did know it was coming. We'd been signalled that there would be significant write-down of assets, and some may argue that this should have happened 2 or 3 years ago. And this is, in fact, the reason why the results were delayed. Just getting the right information around those write-downs and a bit of extra scrutiny. But on the plus side, operating expenditure and the capital expenditure have both been reduced significantly, which has freed up cash flow and allowed the co-op to repay some debt. So that's a good thing.
It hasn't freed up enough cash flow to pay out dividends, though. Is that going to hit farmers?
It will hit farmers. We've had no dividends for 2 years. But I did see in the results that came out, they've got a forecast earnings per share for 19/20 of 15 to 25 cents with a 5-year plan to get that to 50 cents. So that's good news, Hayley.
Well, it sounds like you're actually looking at the bright side of things here. Are you optimistic about Fonterra's new strategy?
Well, yeah, I am optimistic, Hayley, and I think I'm a bit of a glass half full kind of a person, so I try and look at the bright side of things. In terms of the strategy, there is some good stuff in there. On first sort of glance, I think it does look good. It is a strategy for the time. The old strategy was during a time of growth and, really big expansion. And that was the V3 strategy about volume, value and velocity. We're now moving to, some could call it the H3 or the healthy three, healthy people, healthy environment, healthy business. And top of that list is focus on New Zealand milk, which gets a really big tick. It's also no longer about having more cows and getting more value. It's no longer about having more cows. It's actually about getting more value out of the cows that we have. A lot of people will be pleased to see that. And it's a move to get more out of the components of the milk that add value to our customers. So we can't feed the world. We really must look after our environment and people as well as communities.
Yeah, and that's what the CEO, Miles Hurrell, has been saying, that he wants to sell New Zealand and our environment and how healthy the milk is when it gets to market. Are you happy with his performance?
I think Miles is doing a great job. He's a great CEO, and I think he's the man for the job at the moment.
He's the man. And do you think it was a good idea to take the eye off global dominance and actually bring the focus back here?
Yeah, well, as I said, that was the strategy before. We were in a different sort of different world and in an expansion and a growth phase. And now, now more than ever, we really have to nurture our environment, look after our people. People are number one. And we have to leverage off our competitive advantage, Hayley, and the IP that we have as a company and a country, and help create long-term value, not only for New Zealand shareholders, but for New Zealand as a nation.
Hey, thank you so much, Tracey, for your optimistic outlook. We really appreciate that this morning. Tracey Brown from the Dairy Environment Leaders Forum.